Previously on Beer and Board Games.
Dungeon World! The village elder has hired this group of adventurers to stop the dragon, Dracurus Basak, from taking massive dumps all over the land.
So she's gonna do that booty clap. She's gonna give it to us.
What's a booty clap?
That's where you turn around, you make the booty go clap. Won't you join us as we journey through Dungeon World? Journey? I want to try something. Can you just keep your head still?
Come on, shove them all in there, boys.
I'm going to put some dice in there.
Oh, dice.
I think that the pencils
are the dice.
I'm going to be the key master.
That key is too heavy.
Don't stay.
With beer.
Oh, yes, beer. If you horbe, man.
Tonight we're drinking Warhammer Coffee Milk Porter.
Ooh.
What the hell is that?
For the Emperor!
Coffee milk porter. It sounds like something you have for breakfast. Ha ha, coffee in the milk time.
Oh wow, it tastes like sour milk and beer.
Oh god!
Man, this beer's fucked up.
Bullshit!
This tastes like a farmer's market.
Hey, I know you were wondering who sponsored this episode. Well, it was Kenneth Roundtree.
Roundtree!
Yeah! Roundtree!
Thanks, Kenneth.
I missed.
You guys, continue onward through the dragon's lair.
No!
You're a little too excited there, Eugene.
Sir Eugene is giddy with excitement when he stumbles across a poor, helpless birdman.
We must help this abomination of nature.
He's probably having a hard time getting up and flying again. I pick him up and throw him.
He falls down to the earth and makes a loud, thickening crunch.
Well, I'm gonna heal him.
He's dead.
Oh, he dead.
You can't heal no next snap.
His brain is still alive. He's only been dead for a moment, and I can heal him.
Okay, Mr. Frankenstein.
Why do you guys want him dead so bad? I can heal him. The Birdman can help us by being our eye in the sky.
All right, give it a shot, buddy.
And it does nothing.
Oh, you just wasted. I try to suck the healing potion out like a snake wound.
You murdered him.
I was trying to help him.
No, you were not.
Yeah, but I mean, he was.
You did it purely out of malice.
I mean, he was already pretty close to dead.
You didn't know that. I'm just saying you did a fucking terrible thing, and you've affected my relationship to you. I don't know if I can be a friend anymore.
Yes.
There's no bards going to be singing songs about, like, the guy who was sorry he killed a bird man.
No, you have no respect for life.
Morrissey the bard would sing that.
Continuing down, you hear the unmistakable squeaking noises of a clown's nose.
I knew you'd be excited.
Clown.
How do they serve the greater society?
What the fuck do you care about society? You're barbarian.
My culture.
You abandoned your culture.
But how would they serve my culture if I...
We go to the fucking clown. I'm not listening to this clown. I'm going towards the literal clown.
Good one.
There is a clown juggling three cacti.
Wow.
Entertaining a whole group of goblins.
We must save the clown.
Wait.
I got an idea. Why don't you throw him?
We can take care of this.
I attack the goblins, all three of them.
You're assuming we want to kill them. We just need to get past them.
I want to kill him.
Who cares about him?
I'm full of bloodlust now.
Appetite for destruction.
I
welcome to the jungle, baby.
My goal is peace in this.
You shut the fuck up.
Well, guess what? Both of you, the brute, the fucking Birdman murderer, and you, the dummy who can't read books, no one's ever going to be safe unless there's peace.
I put the sack that I stole from him over his head.
Ha!
Attack the goblins.
Attack goblins. All right, roll a hack and slash, which is your strength.
10.
Wowza.
So, how many goblins do I kill? That'll be 2.
I'm also attacking goblins.
How many?
However many it takes.
Don't listen to Baghead.
Plus 1, 7.
Damn, son, you hit!
9 points of damage!
One goblin down, I've got a bag in my head, so I'm of no use.
That's your own fault.
No. Casting an invisibility spell on myself.
Okay, are you removing the bag from your head first?
Nope, leaving it on.
The bag is invisible.
I'm gonna shoot a magic missile at these
fuckers. Magic missile. Roll you 2 dice.
These boys are gonna get a little red rocket up the ass. So, 7.
One of the goblins explodes in a fireball of magic. Swing your sword, brother.
Yeah, obliteration. You sliced and diced him.
How do you know I've gained a level?
You haven't. Just fucking figure out what you're doing.
That's a strange question. How do you know that I've gained a level?
I don't. I guess it's another magic missile. I'm firing a magic missile.
Okay.
Six.
That's
and
enough.
Then I ain't scared.
So the goblins explode in a massive spray of gore.
Please, good clown, tell us how to find the dragon.
Oh, the dragon's out right now. That means we can escape.
No, we must find his treasure.
And slay him.
If you continue down this hallway, you will find the dragon's lair. Do not take from his mountain of wealth, for he knows.
Well, I think we should continue down the hallway and find that dragon.
Please?
Come on.
A little wine? We'll catch a movie? No?
Stay away from me.
You don't feel anything?
I have a question for you, Eugene. How big is your butt?
I am fit and bulky.
You fill out those pants so good.
Booty clap? Is that possible? Can you do that?
No, my religion forbids me from booty clapping.
But I mean, okay.
Ooh, let me use some telepathy and make that motherfucker think he's got it.
Not how telepathy works.
I'm fucking charm person, dude. You got charm person.
Charm person.
I'm gonna charm him.
All right. We're gonna see if it works.
We're gonna make that fucking booty clap tonight.
I will attack you and kill you.
I can see the seams on those pants be busting. Oh, I can't help myself. 8 + 2, 9.
The person you touch while casting the spell counts you as a friend until they take damage or you prove otherwise.
Oh, so you can't just control my mind. I just think that you're my friend. Which I'm obviously mistaken. So you can't make me do a fucking booty clap. You just wasted your spell.
Would you booty clap for a friend?
I would not.
Would you booty clap for a girlfriend or a boyfriend?
Time to move on.
All right.
To a new room. Who wants to choose from my little stack?
My little stack.
Who wants to choose from my little stack?
That's a guy just starting out rapping. I got my tiny stack.
I got mad thin stacks of $1 bills.
Yes.
Oh, you've aged.
Sudden.
It's Benjamin the curse of the Birdman.
Birdman. I really like that idea. We're going to make that a reality.
Wait a minute, what?
The Birdman was cursed.
No.
And since you slew him, you now have his curse.
No, I didn't. You never said that. You can't just say that.
This game is all
about
displayers.
What was his fucking curse?
He killed a Birdman and now he's making up some bullshit to punish him. Yeah. I'm all for it.
Dude, I should be getting rewarded for killing a Birdman.
Why?
Because he's a fucking Birdman.
Avianist.
When you try to do something that this curse applies to, I'll let you know.
Oh, good.
You ready?
All right, mystery curse.
You adventurers have stumbled into the middle of an arena. You're
what?
Surrounded by massive, dirty, flesh-eating ogres. Fortunately, some of the ogres are painted blue, and some are painted red.
Is there an audience?
There is an audience.
People, humans, or orcs?
Kobolds.
We're the referees. Tell them we're the referees. You can whistle, though. Just do the thing that all the assholes do at concerts.
I whistle.
Yes, he whistles like a referee.
Actually, I whistle. I go, whoop, whoop.
And then I go like this.
The ogres charge at each other. Start killing and slaughtering each other.
Yes.
And the kobolds are cheering. Mm-hmm. The female ones are taking off their tops.
Oh.
You know.
The females that are taking off their tops, those are hobolds.
We need more hobolds like that. It'll bring peace to the land.
For showbolds.
For showbolds.
For showbolds. For showbolds.
So, after a long, drawn-out battle with tons of ups and downs...
Yeah, I can't believe how enjoyable this is.
It's really fun.
Look at all the titties.
I thought you were a good person.
I am a good person, but I'm lonely.
Finally, there was one blue ogre standing over the last red ogre. And the blue ogre looks over at you guys.
Safe!
And he puts down his sword and walks his swanky ogre ass through the gate.
Wow.
Fuck around and get your bitch chained up!
You gotta be rich, you gotta be quick, you gotta be sexy if you wanna make it in this business.
Mom's spaghetti.
I understand that you have a story to tell us about something that happened when you were a young person.
So I had this pair of pants, right? Acid wash was very popular. I'm gonna acid wash my jeans for real. And I got some bleach, filled up a bucket, And I put one leg of the jeans into the bucket.
All right, I'm with you.
And it was just completely, like, bone white. Up to, you know, like, right about crotch level.
Wow!
And I think I wore them once to, like, school. I probably got beat up by 6 or 7 different people. And I was like, maybe that was a bad idea.
Maybe I shouldn't have been wearing this cape and carrying this box of super dudes at the same time.
Okay, these pants are useless. So I gave up the pants. About 8 years later, I visited my dad, and he was wearing a pair of pants with one leg bleached all the way up. He had, like, found them and been like, oh, perfectly good pair of pants.
What would you expect from Cape Date Senior? I have to admit, I didn't think that story was going to pay off, but it sure did.
Yeah, now Tony Trout's going to think... Well, what's his name, a.k.a. Tony Trout, is going to think that I made up that story.
You know that story you told about the strange jeans?
Oh, yes.
He put them in a bucket or something? What if he just made that up?
That's right.
To further himself.
I would like to thank everybody who donates on a monthly basis to us at Subbable.com/beer and board games.
If you haven't gone to Subbable.com/beer and board games, you can do that. There's all kinds of rewards you can get, and you can make monthly donations, little increments to build towards those rewards. You don't have to shell out all the money all at once. Do it over the months. Subbable.com.
Busy beer and board games.
Busy beer and board games.
Busy beer and
board games.
Busy beer and board games.
Busy
beer and
board games.
Busy beer and
board games.
But I don't like all the meanness.
I don't think I've been that mean to you tonight. I think you're feeling sensitive.
You called me fucking stupid.
But you're Sir Eugene. You gave yourself low intelligence.
What have I said to you that was an insult?
You did.
What?
Well, I don't remember. Do you guys remember?
Oh, I don't remember. He doesn't remember.
Well, let's...
Maybe because it never happened?
Let's run the tape.
All I remember is him saying, like, hey, I really like you, David. You're my favorite guy that I know.
That never happened.
Yeah, let's roll the tapes.
Yeah, let's roll them.
Let's just go back to 1975. Let's roll those fucking tapes. Just roll them back.
Someday I'll meet a guy named David.
All right. We're going to a dragon room. We're going to fight a dragon. We're all going to die. I know it, but this is the way to go.
You see a massive pile of gold. Huge.
Stop. Don't you remember?
Fuck that clown.
What did he say? I forgot.
He said if he takes from the dragon, he'll find you. But I don't believe that shit.
We're going to make that dragon booty go clap.
Dragon booty go clap. I plunge my fists into the treasure mound and I pour it over myself in ecstasy.
Make it rain!
That is a blatant display of pimpism. You a pimp.
I think he's getting too drunk.
Yeah, I think so.
Several long moments go by, and then a rumbling.
Oh my god.
As a massive dragon crashes through the hole that was there the entire time, but you never cared to look, and it lands on the massive pile of gold and looks right at the three of you.
Oh, I didn't touch it. I
can't see me. I'm invisible.
I cast invisibility on myself.
Motherfucker.
You have to roll for that.
Oh, that's a big failure.
Your spell is gone.
I say we try to talk to him. Maybe he'll shit in a special area and we won't have to kill him. Vestibule.
Tell him all this.
Hey, dragon.
Yes!
We just want to talk.
About what?
Okay, we get it. He's loud. So now you can just talk in a normal voice.
Okay, about what?
You can stop.
You poop too much. People don't like it.
We get it.
We understand you have to poop.
You can just talk in a normal voice.
Come on, America loves this voice.
What if we create a special place for you to poop that gives you benefits?
I believe you called it a vestibule.
A vestibule. We put gold in...
You wish... to bribe the great Dracarys Bussac.
It would be a sacrifice.
A Bussacrifice.
It would be a sack full of gold.
A Bussac full of gold.
What are you doing?
From I'm hiding.
Me?
You kid!
You're hiding
the dragon is everywhere.
Where did he go? I don't see him.
Yeah, I'm shooting a magic missile.
Okay, do it.
Here it comes.
I was this close to agreeing to your vestibule.
7.
All you needed to do was say there would be a person that you could poop on. Oh, fuck, dude. Nice.
6 damage. Wow.
What?
We could tell the dragon that he's the first sack.
Yes! Stop it. You already went. You did your thing.
Yeah, man, you already did your thing.
This wizard is our first sacrifice.
Hey!
I'm dodging that shit.
Okay, the dragon claps his ass in your direction. Which is what you've always wanted.
Yeah, I'm liking this so far.
Unfortunately, 300 pounds of feces are coming your way.
Must be Tuesday again.
I'm going to... This is a plus. I got to see that booty go clap. Boom!
What can I say? We made a bargain with a dragon. And folks, we had a good time tonight.
So did I.
Good night.
You were pimp.